finish off with a bit of core and then work your abs. So we're just going to do two sets of 30 second planks. So standard plank position. So just get down onto your elbows. And normally you might just get to lift your knees up so you're on your hips. However, because we've done a few sessions before, you can see I've got some blocks behind you. So what we're going to do, drop down and place your feet on the blocks.
Okay.
So you're going to see holding that plank position like that for 30 seconds.
Right.
For the blood rushing to begin. Good, good. Awesome. Drop down. Good. It helps when you're elevated. It's just a some increased plank, I guess. It's because it puts more pressure on your abdomen because your legs are raised. You're causing the weight to sort of slide down slightly. So it puts more pressure on your abdomen and your glutes. Everybody wants some nice glute muscles, max muscles. And your shoulders. 5 seconds left of this one. 5 seconds. Now I need to research my stretches. Yeah, done for that one. Just drop down to your knees. Stay there for me. And then 10 seconds, we'll go again. Next one done. How does that feel? Resetting. Strong. Strong board. Go. Strong. Good. It's important to have a strong core because it helps everything else become a lot easier. Your core becomes engaged in day-to-day life. Everything you do engages some sort of muscle that's usually associated with your core. Everyone loves a core. Yeah, and we're done.